Tonight on 60 Minutes, the return of Point Counterpoint. Here to debate the impending war in Iraq are former President Bill Clinton and Senator Bob Dole.
Bob, how did our diplomatic strategy on Iraq fall apart so badly, so fast? In a little over 2 years, this administration has squandered every foreign policy achievement of the 90s, and through its arrogant, unilateral approach, has succeeded only in provoking our enemies and alienating our friends. Not a day goes by that I don't get a phone call from some head of state who'll ask me, "What the hell is going on in your country?" When you were president, the economy was booming, the world was at peace, America was admired and respected throughout the world. Can't you do something? And I'll tell them that while I appreciate their kind words and share some of their concerns, I feel that it would be inappropriate for me to undermine President Bush by publicly criticizing him. And they'll say, "But you were so great to work with as president. You were so visionary, so well informed. Can't you run again in 2004? And again, I thank them, but point out that I served my 2 terms. And I feel I should give others a chance. And they'll say, "But you're still so young. In 2004, you'll only be 58. And that's younger than most presidents are in their first term." And I'll just say, "Well, that's true. And the Constitution does permit me to run for a third non-consecutive term, or it ought to." But right now, 2004 is the furthest thing from my mind. "Well, please consider it," they'll say, "because God, we need you. The world needs you." And of course, I thank Tony Blair, or Jacques Chirac, or Mr. Putin, or Pervez Musharraf, or Kofi Annan, or Jean Chrétien, or Jiang Zemin, or whoever it is. Nelson Mandela calls a lot. He's a fan. It's all very flattering, and it's all very sweet. But the fact is, I'm enjoying my retirement from public life, and I'm just a private citizen who wants to support President Bush in any way I can. And the best advice I can give him right now is to go back to the United Nations, let the inspectors do their jobs, keep the pressure on, and work with our allies in France, Germany, and Russia.
Bill, you ignorant slut. Saddam Hussein is a boil that needs to be lanced, and we're going to lance it. So why don't you and your little European pals just run along and have a garden party, eat your sandwiches with the crust cut off and the watercress salad for dessert, put on your tiny little swimsuits, frolic on the lawn, throw a beach ball like a girl, explore the different aspects of your sexuality. And you just step aside and let us, the British, the Spanish, and the Estonians, take care of business. Well, I got you. Here's another thing. Tell your Hillary to lay off my wife, Liddy. She's a senator now. She doesn't have to take that kind of guff she's been getting from your old lady. Next time she comes home to me in tears because Hillary's made some snide remark about her in the Senate cloakroom, or she's rolled her eyes at my wife in a committee hearing, I'm going to jump in my car, head over to the Capitol, and beat her like a rented mule. And don't think the Secret Service or Capitol Police can protect her, because I know how to get the drop on her. I know every secret passageway, trap door, and revolving bookcase in that building. Sooner or later, I'll get her alone. When I do, I'll kick her hippie behind like it's never been kicked. And by the way, I don't want to hear any more Viagra or Britney Spears jokes. I'm not ashamed of my commercial endorsements. I have a family to provide for, and I didn't have the rich Hollywood friends buying me houses, the no-show job at DreamWorks, or the $10 million advance on a book. Bob Dole didn't have those things. Now, you look me in the eye, and tell me that you've written one page in that book, Bill Clinton. You can't, because you haven't written word one. Because you are what you have always been, an indolent, borderline, sociopathic, hedonistic, sexual predator, full of pointy-headed, Oxford-bred socialism that would have us all dragged back to the era of Stalin, Mao, and Ho Chi Minh.
This has been Point Counterpoint. And now, live from New York, it's Saturday Night.